slaughterhouse, an Orthodox slaughterhouse in Argentina, used to have every morning a group of slaughterers, a shochatim, that used to come with a van to the work, organized van, and when they used to go home, it was the same thing. A van used to take them home. One night, as they're about to take off, the guard tells them, "I think that you really forgot someone." And when they said no, "We checked the building, everything is empty." But before they left, they went inside to check if really everyone left. They checked from door to door, and then they got to the freezer. They opened to the freezer. They were shivering. They were shocked to see that one of them was left inside. And when they asked him what happened, he said, "I got locked inside and knocked on the door. See if someone can save me. Or when I saw it's not coming, I thought that it's about to happen the worst from everything. And then came my salvation." They asked the guard, "How did you realize that someone is missing?" He says, "This particular guy makes sure that every morning when he comes, he says, 'Good morning, have a wonderful day.' When he leaves by night, he tells me, 'Good night, have a good night.' This saying, 'Good morning,' saved this slaughter's life, literally. How big is the saying 'Good morning' in the morning?" This parasha, Parshat Yitro, we're reading about the meeting between Moshe and Yitro. Moshe, the Torah, is the Mechilta for Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, says, he did not start telling him, "You have no idea the miracles that we had when we went out of Egypt." No. He did not start telling him, "You know what happened when we crossed the sea." He did not even tell him, "You know how we're getting food every morning? It comes down from heaven, food every morning, the man." No. First thing he said, as the Mechilta says, "Va'ishalu ish lere'eyu l'shalom." They first asked, they were greeting each other. Then they started the day. As the Mechilta is adding, and this made the conversation much easier afterward, as they continue to speak. And as we see, which means very simple, when we meet another person, how do we have to start the conversation? Don't start telling him, "You know how much I'm learning every day? You know how much I'm davening, how much mitzvot I'm doing? You know how much money I have in the bank?" No. First thing that we have to do, we have to tell him, "Good morning," or "Hi, how are you? How do you feel? Is everybody okay? Everything okay?" Then start telling him what you want to tell him. And this makes everything a lot better and smoother afterward. And sometimes it can save your life, like the story with the shochet, with the slaughter. And as we finished, and this is the lesson to us, a lesson to us, the way we have to greet, who is greater than Moshe Rabbeinu? That Moshe Rabbeinu, when he met his father-in-law, he did not start with the miracles. First, he was trying to find out how Yitro himself is doing. And Yitro did exactly the same thing. Like the Mishnah says, Rab Matya ben Harash Omer, it says in Perkei Avot, "Eve magdim b'shlom kol adam." You should be the one first greeting every single person. That's the way we should conduct our life. Shabbat Shalom.